first answer is that they have to figure it out themselves. So when I was a student myself, I was independently looking for reality, and I believe that if you talk with your friends at the same age and the millennials and this type of people, they really understand the world, the future of the world, much better than ourselves, because they are going to be the future. So you are going to be the future in 20 years. So people around you are going to be the other directors, are going to be your colleagues, your peers, are going to be the new director in 20 years, in 30 years. So they're going to be politicians, they're going to be the people that will drive the world and will run the world. So the answer for what is the future doesn't come from us, in my opinion. So we can just have a little bit of aim of not be commoditized too quickly, let's put it in this way. So I believe, as I said before, that in artificial intelligence, the problem is today being able to reason logically like humans are doing. But that's also kind of an old paradigm that comes back, maybe because of my background. So I believe that many other people are looking, as I said, for multimedia and multimodality in general, being able to put together all these modalities. And related to news, I believe there is something interesting going on now. So I'm working for several projects in the United States, and as you know, the problem of identifying truth in news is a very important one today. So because before there used to be this paradigm where the trustable newspapers were the truth, and everybody followed from that. So it was pretty easy for a person to assess the validity, authenticity of this information. So you just compare what the blog or what the news with some trustable source, and that's it. Today, there is, with social media, the spread of information is so huge and confusing. In my opinion, is creating some type of semiotic distortion, I don't know how to call it, but because we are usually reinforcing our beliefs after the frequency of the things that we hear. But with social media, these things are going out of control. And I believe that the idea of coming back to the basics and make sure that artificial intelligence is the way to somehow understand the authenticity of information and give back the humanity the ability to believe in something is a very big challenge, and not for the future, but it's for today. So I've been working on that at IBM, and there is a huge interest. So today, whoever will be able to solve the fake news problem is going to win Nobel Prize, I believe. Because that's really what is changing politics, what is changing the world. So we all know that there is these Russian hackers that are changing the result of elections. These actually are a threat for our democracy. So it's not a minor thing. And ICT is the somehow one of the ingredients and solution for that. So I believe that in the short term, if you can solve this problem, it will be a big win. For the future, as I said, so maybe it's up to the new generation to tell us what the future will be.